A citizen is a member who belongs to a political community with rights and obligations entitled to him or her. There are three aspects that are supposed to be understood when we are talking about a citizen. The first one is the political community that one belongs to. The political community defines a citizen. The people who are within the confines of this political authority or community are referred to as citizens of Zimbabwe. Another aspect which defines a citizen is that of rights. Citizens have rights as enshrined in their constitution and also as determined by the political authority in which they reside. Besides the rights, they also have got what are referred to as obligations. Obligations are the expectations that the state or the political authority expect them to do. Citizenship refers now to the relationship that exists between an individual and a state in which this individual resides. There is a symbiotic relationship that exists between a citizen and the state. And this relationship creates what became what we call citizenship. Now, a citizen or citizenship as a concept is defined by these three aspects. Number one, the state in which one belongs, the political rights, socio-economic rights the individual has, as well as the obligations that one should have. Individuals in a particular geographical area or political authority or community are entitled to certain rights, such as the right to vote, such as the right to education, right to food, right to shelter, decent shelter, and they are also entitled to protection, safety, and their security should be ensured by the state in which they belong to. And then the second aspect is now of the obligations. Now, once the state will guarantee the rights of these people or these individuals, there is also need for them to give back to the state. How? These are now what we call obligations. One of the key obligations of a citizen is to ensure that there is respect of political authority. Number one, there is also conformity to the rules and the laws that defines the territorial boundary in which one resides. These are normally enshrined or contained in various statutes, which are, among other things, the constitution and various statutes which govern local and administrative authorities within the country. How then does one become a citizen of a particular country? In the case of Zimbabwe, we have three forms in which one becomes a citizen of Zimbabwe. The first one, you can become a citizen of Zimbabwe by birth. For individuals who are born in Zimbabwe, by members of the Zimbabwean community, automatically they become citizens of Zimbabwe. Right? These can be children born outside Zimbabwe by parents whose origins can be traced back to Zimbabwe. Automatically they also become Zimbabweans. That is citizenship by birth. And then the second aspect, you can also become a citizen of Zimbabwe through registration. One can be a registered member of Zimbabwe through marriage, residing, married to a Zimbabwean or married to a Zimbabwean and lived with a Zimbabwean for 5 years, one would automatically also qualify to be registered as a Zimbabwean citizen. By descent, we are referring to the origins or an individual has. This can be derived from parents or grandparents. Some parents might have migrated to other areas, but their origins can be traced back to Zimbabwe. That individual can also become a Zimbabwean by descent. Be it parents or grandparents who might have had their origins in Zimbabwe, that individual can also be entitled to enjoy full citizenship of Zimbabwe.